Before we continue, I would like to organize the outline a tiny bit because we have rename these things. So the plane we just created, I'm gonna just call that roof. Then we also have two cubes here. One of them is the two beams. So I'm just gonna beams. Here we go. Oh, we already have something called beams. Okay, beams 001, that's fine. And the cube, this will just be roof structure, something like that. Just something descriptive. Okay, so let's take a look at the floor plan. So what I am gonna do is, I think I'm just gonna pull the floor plan out of this collection. That way I can quickly hide the everything else. So let's take a look at the floor plan. So this curved wall is going to be a bit of a challenge to create, and this is the stairs, but I think we should just dive right in. And the first thing, we need to match the curvature. So we're going to do like a circle, and let's just go into the add menu, shift A, and create a circle from the mesh menu. And it's probably 32 for you here in this vertices option. If you don't see this menu, make sure that you open it up. It might appear like a little black box down in the lower left corner like this. You just have to open it up, and then you have access to these options, and then just increase this to like 500, a high number, really high number. If you don't see this menu at all, you might need to go up to view up here and make sure that adjust last operation is checked. And then if you create the circle, this menu should pop up. All right. Create the circle that has 500 vertices and the radius of 24.5. Let's start there. And then in top view, I'm going to zoom in because I'm going to press G to move it. And I'm looking at that orange dot there, which is the origin point or the center of the circle. I'm zooming in, and I just want to match that circle, that center of the circle, to this step. And I'm doing that because this is the only straight step in the staircase. With it in place, I'm going to press G and then X to move it precisely just on the X-axis and move it to the side. See how it fits. You can see down here in the bottom that it's not fitting really well. And now it's 49 by 49 meters. I'm going to left click and drag over these two values, and I'm going to type in 46.5 because I've got that written down somewhere that that's the correct measurement. And then it gets a bit smaller, and then you just press G and X again to move it back into place. And we can see that it fits the curvature quite nicely. I'm just going to move it back into place, so pressing G and X. Something like this. I can see it's going off a bit of the drawing here, but it seems to fit on both sort of ends. So I'm gonna stick to that. Okay, so this is our cutting object. And now is also a good time to press Shift S and choose this option here, cursor to select it. Because now the 3D cursor is sitting in the pivot point of this sort of circle. So all the details and everything we do on the stairs, we can then use the 3D cursor as the sort of pivot point of rotation or whatever. So now we've got that location sort of set. So now it's time to create the actual stairs. We're gonna make another object, but before we do that, we're gonna rename this circle cutter. Alright, and now we're going to create another circle. By default, it's going to have the same properties as the last one, so 500 vertices and 24.5 in radius. We don't care so much about the radius. Let's actually increase it a bit more so it reaches outside, like so it overlaps the stairs a bit, something like this. But the vertices, we're going to decrease them a lot. Let me see what makes sense. There's something like this. So we want like a gap that covers each sort of set, each flight of stairs. Now we can go into edit mode, and with all of them selected, just make sure by pressing A, I'm gonna hit E to extrude and S to scale. So now I'm just scaling the extrusion down. So I'm just gonna make sure I cover the stairs, something like this. And I'm gonna go to wireframe view, make sure X-ray is enabled, and I'm going to go to face select. I'm gonna choose these two faces, holding down shift and left click on the second one, and I'm going to press control and I. So that's invert. So invert my selection, press X and delete faces. All right, so now I only got these two faces instead of the whole circle. Don't need anything else. And now what we want to do is to actually match those lines. We have to create more loop cuts to sort of fit the stairs. This one we can press G and G, so double G, and then move them alongside our edges, and I'm gonna just match it to this one. And for this one, GG, and just move it to the this side. I'm gonna do the same on the other side, just sort of move it in place. But now we're missing one here, so I'm just gonna press Control and R to get a loop cut, drop it in there and put it there. So now that we have defined the top and the bottom of each sort of flight, we can now use the loop cut tool inside each of these segments here. So just Control and R, and then we can use the scroll wheel to just match the number of steps like this, and then left click, right click, and we've done that part. Same on the other side, left click and right click. So now we have made like these segments, but they're completely flat. There's no height to them, and that is fine for now, because we want to use now the circle that we created to cut this sort of a shape. We want to actually cut the outer shape. Okay, so S to scale and to something like there. Perfect. And I want to move this down because this is sort of flying. It's in the height of 387. And I want to just put that to 0. So that's in the sidebar. You get the by pressing N. And this object, I'm going to go into edit mode of that, and I'm going to give it some body, a little bit of a thickness there, and I'm going to move it down so it cuts through it like this. I can hide my floor plan so we can see this a bit better. So now it's just cutting through, right? And now we can use the Boolean tool just like we did with the ceiling. So choosing this part and going into the modifiers, sorry, here the blue wrench icon, and finding the Boolean, using the eyedropper just to click on that circle, and it is, you can see that now if we use the difference, it is going to cut everything out that we actually want to keep. So you can use the intersect instead, and we can actually just apply this Boolean immediately. So hover over the Boolean modifier and press Control A, or you can also go to this drop down menu and just choose apply. So I want to get the floor plan back. Oh yeah, here we go. In the wireframe view, I want to move the circle, the cutter object, I want to move that back to the inner wall like so. Something like this, because we can actually use this to just create that curved wall. S and Z is just scaling on the Z axis, and I'm just going to scale it up a bit. I'm not going to think about the actual, like the actual scale. So the cutting object, cutter object, or the wall there, I'm going to hide it by pressing H, and I will just sort of do the same thing as pressing that eye icon. And choose the stairs, go to edit mode. Now we just need to push them up gradually. And how I'm going to do that, we're just going to press A to select everything, and I'm going to press E to extrude, and then 0.15. Oh, went the wrong way. If that is the case, we can do one thing. If you just go to edit mode and you select everything, press spacebar to search, and then you can type in flip and mesh normals flip. So flip normals. So now you just basically flip the direction of the surface. So now if you select everything, press E and then type in 1.15, it should go up rather than down. It also lives up here. Mesh normals flip. Okay, so now what I would like to do is to deselect the first step by holding down shift and left clicking on it, and then just press shift and R, and it will repeat that 15 centimeter extrusion. And then I'll just shift and left click, shift and R, shift and left click. So basically you can just hold down shift and then just press R and left click sort of in a sequence like this. And when you've done this, we will also be able to sort of change the scale of it, because we can push it all down and all up. So if you want the steps to be taller, we can just sort of scale the whole object up and down. This is arguably not the best way to do this. This is sort of like a really straightforward way. There are some more technical ways of achieving the same result, but I, after like trying out maybe 5 different methods of doing this curved stair, this was the one that I thought was the most straightforward, and using tools that we have already sort of been using. Didn't want to dump too much stuff on you in this video. So now we can also see that this wall definitely needs to be taller. So I'm gonna select that in object mode, pressing S and Z, and just scale it up quite a bit. It doesn't really harm anything that it goes too high, because we won't see the top bit of it anyway. Going to front view, I'm just gonna make sure that it's sitting on the ground. So I'm gonna enable the snapping option. Well, actually I can also see it just here in the transform options. It is sitting there on the Z axis with some value there. So I'm gonna take that down to 0. And we got this beautiful curved wall with these amazing looking stairs. And then of course we can just from the top step, we can just take that top face there and just extrude that out to give us like a little bit of a walking space up there on the top floor. Okay, so now if we show the rest of the gallery space and we go back into it, we can now see how it sits. And we should probably actually create that door which is sitting there. So I'm gonna go to top view, wireframe, x-ray, and with the circle selected, I'm gonna go to edit mode and make sure that I have some, oh, I'm gonna be in vertex select mode as well, and just make sure that I have vertices on the corners here. So I'm gonna box select, because this is gonna be, I'm also selecting the bottom vertices, not just the top one. So selecting everything and just pressing GG, so I'm not sort of destroying that curve, just living on that curve there, and just moving it into place like there. And same with the one on the other side, moving it into place like so. And now we are trusting the drawing in terms of the width, but we actually have the width, which is 220. So we will make sure in a bit that this is 220, and that's easy to change afterwards as well. But okay, we need the height, and the height of this door is actually not put in, but according to the photos, it's just slightly, it seems to be like a bit less than 220, so maybe like 25 or something. But we're gonna do this with a loop cut, Control and R, and I'm just gonna drop it in there and just right click or left click just to confirm this. And then from the front view, I'm just looking at this grid in the background there. I can see the 2 meters is here. So I'm just going to press GG and just move it down. And so this is 210, 220. So let's just go for something like 205. If we ever find out the actual measurement of this door, we can always change this, and it's not really difficult to change it. But now also taking a look at the whole thing here, this is a lot of vertices that we're not using. So what I'm gonna do is make sure that I'm in wireframe and x-ray, and I'm gonna go up to maybe, I want to maybe keep this part and this part. So it's something like there. So now I've selected everything that I want to keep. So then I want to invert my selection. So you can do Control I, or you also have a select menu up here, which shows you the same option, invert. With it selected, press X and vertices. So now we have sort of limited that wall a bit, but it's completely infinitely thin. So we want to give it some thickness. So from top view, I want to go to the modifier stack with it selected, in object mode, add modifier and solidify. So something like we did with the ceiling. And I'm just gonna sort of eyeball it. It seems to be like this, which is what, 31? Yeah, okay. So I'm gonna just call it 30 centimeters and change the offset to 1 instead of minus 1. Amazing. And now we can also, that's also a new shortcut for you maybe, Alt and Set is going between x-ray and non-x-ray. And in x-ray view, we can see that these vertices, holding down shift to select all of them, we just don't need them, we can just delete them, because that basically means that we will get that door. So X and delete vertices. So now you can see, if I go into update mode, that we have this beautiful looking door. And now if I go into my camera view by pressing 0, hiding the sidebar, I'm gonna find my camera in the outliner, just there. And in the camera settings, in this green icon here, I can change the focal length. Now it's 37, I can change it to something like 18. So we can already see that the space is starting to look pretty good. We can compare it to a photograph of it. So it seems to sort of be pretty accurate to how the space looks. And I really want to fix that stair problem there before we do anything else. So the quickest way to do that is to actually just create another cutting object, a circle, or yeah, let's just do a circle. And we have the 3D cursor correctly placed there. If it is not sitting there, you can always select your wall piece, which the origin point should be over there, and then you can go and shift, press Shift S, and then cursor to select it. It's important that it's there because we're going to create a new circle, which pops up there, and we want to change the vertices to just a really high number, 500. That's fine. And now we want to go into wireframe and x-ray view, and we want to match the size of this to the line that we want to cut, which is going to be just right in the middle of the wall perhaps, because it's fine that it goes a bit into the wall, because we definitely do not want to have like a gap between the stairs and the wall. So something like this, that's perfect. And now we just have to give it a bit of a thickness. So going into edit mode and pressing E to extrude, and just set to go straight up. I just go up like this. And I also want to move it slightly down, so we are definitely cutting the whole stairs. We're not leaving like tiny bit of the bottom stair. So just G and set, and moving it just a bit down. Now we know that it's definitely cutting through the whole staircase. Okay, now we're going to go back to solid view. Maybe I'll just hide the roof parts and the ceiling. Maybe the beams as well. There we go. So I'm gonna select my stairs, and now from the, and if you don't have a boolean modifier here, you just add that in by, if you find it in the generate section, and then you in the object, now we are gonna use this this new circle that is just called circle, but I'm just gonna use the eyedropper, something like that, and then I'm gonna apply this, choose the circle, delete. And now I have cut my little staircase so it fits the wall. and it's not gonna make any problems inside there. Now I'm gonna show these things again, everything except the cutting object, that except that one. Another thing we need to do now is to create a cutting object that cuts from the ceiling here, so you can actually walk up the stairs without without just walking into the ceiling. So from top view, I wanna look at the floor plan, but before that I wanna name these stairs and curved wall, just to have these organized, and move these two into this collection here, so everything is there. Oh, I moved the wrong object. Stairs, keep the floor plan out. Here we go. Now I'm gonna go to top view and hide my collection and take a look. And it is this, seems to be this dotted line here. That is the cutting object that we need to create. So we can just do that by creating a circle, mesh circle. And let's just scale it to the inner line. So, or actually I think it is the whole, we can just, it's not this dotted line, that's the stairs. So it just goes into the wall. So we can just make the cutting object going into the wall like this. And then in edit mode, by pressing tab, pressing E and S, so extrude and scale, and then just match the other line, something like there. Go to the X-ray view there. And let's just match with edge select mode up here in left corner. Let's choose this edge there and just match that to that dotted line here. I'm gonna choose this edge here, which we are gonna delete. Press X and just delete vertices. So that means these two vertices will be deleted. And that creates a gap. I'm gonna do the same on the other side. Let's take this, like the top staircase, this top edge of the stairs, and do the same thing. So now we have created two gaps, and a quick way to select mesh is to press L. So L. If you hover over part of the mesh and you press L, it is going to select everything that is connected. So now we just disconnected this little island there, and it's not going to be connected. So that's a quick way to kind of help with selecting objects. But okay, so L and then X and vertices. So now we only have this part. And I want to extend this edge just straight. So that's E and Y. Now I want to just go straight out like that. And now with all of them selected by pressing A, I want to just press it E and then just pull it up a bit, just to create like a object that we can use to cut even a bit more, G and Z, just to make sure that we cut through the ceiling. All right, now I want to show everything again. Disable the X-ray. It's sitting there, and I want to just press G and Z to move it up, just so it overlaps on both sides properly, like the ceiling part. And now we need to create booleans again, choosing the ceiling. We want to go to our boolean, and should actually already have a boolean, which is the making the hole there for this part. And we want to add another boolean modifier. So that's here. And that boolean is going to use this object as a cutting object, and it seems to be making that hole beautifully for us. And now I'm gonna show you a trick of how we can hide these without hiding them. It's kind of a weird thing. So select this object, go into this tab here, which is the object data, object properties, and in the viewport display, you can change textured to wire. Do the same thing with the other one, texture to wire. And then we don't have to hide them from the outliner. They can be there, and we can still select them and move them around. So it's a bit more, it's sort of like best of both worlds there. And also they're then visually as a reminder that we have not applied those modifiers. Now we can also see that this one is causing some problems. So we can just apply the Boolean modifier to this one as well. So, Boolean and circle. Here we go. Now it's making cut for that as well. And now we can see that this is all coming together quite nicely.